NRBS, we are back with another interview. We got TED Ness in the building. Let's give him a clap out here.
Check.
Out here, man.
It's mad.
Right, so I just want to start this off early. When it comes to you, the first thing I think is consistency over a long period of time.
Yeah.
Now, where does that consistency come from as a whole?
It's just my love for music, man. And it's obviously, it's my release. You know what I mean? You live life day to day, and you go through things day to day, and I kind of just rap about what I go through, man. You keep living. So the music don't stop coming.
Do you think that you'll have that consistency if you didn't have the team that is around you?
Six-figure music for sure, man.
Yeah. Cause I feel like I don't know, because I do so much on my own now. Like, I try and be as independent as I can when it comes to, like, making my music, like, recording it, and just trying to be as independent as I can for the team, you know what I mean? Bring something to the table. I feel like I'd be able to do it if I didn't have the team around me.
The first video that I saw of yours, yeah. I think I know what you're going to say already. You were six, mm-hmm. Link Up TV, you're going back to back on a freestyle.
That was actually the first video that kind of got Link Up back up and running again. It got us up and running at the same time. That's kind of why I've always got that love with Link Up, because it kind of started both of us, you know what I mean?
For sure.
That was 2010.
Yeah. Damn. Before that video, what were you doing? Were you still doing music?
We were still doing music, but it just weren't as serious. Like, that was kind of the first serious thing that we did.
When did you start making music, though?
I was like 13, 14.
Wow. How old do you know?
25.
Wow.
Just going to expose his age like that, you know? Just asking his name. You're good with that.
Yeah, I'm good, bro.
I hear that.
A lot of artists try to hide the age.
You know the ones.
They need the younger listening group, so they try to fool the little girls and make them think they're.
I hear that.
There's tactics in this thing, trust me.
For sure.
For sure. Now, also, one thing I wanted to say was, I'm sure anyone that listens to your music hears Six-Figure Music constantly. That's our music tag. So what would you say as a whole with Six-Figure Music? What is Six-Figure? For anyone that doesn't know,
it's a music collective. We're just a music collective. We've got some rappers, producers, engineers, like designers, and there's outside people that do other things. It's just a family, create a family really, man. But it's more of a production house, like a music production house.
Yeah.
Like, it basically means that we can start from scratch, from silence, and have a finished album in-house. Our own engineers, our own beats, our own studios, you know what I mean? So that's the best way to describe it.
What I wanted to ask you is, what is your upbringing? Where are you coming from? What's your story?
How do I explain? I don't know. I was brought up in West London.
West London.
Kind of just grew up over there listening to the olders doing grime. Started in the youth clubs and that, just babbling about. It's just a West London younger MC. And then went on holiday for 20 months. I left the country for a bit. Come back. And
where
then
did you go?
Up with six. Jamaica.
Nice.
I actually told a story. I actually got sent to Jamaica by my mother. It's actually the best thing that ever happened to me, though.
That's real.
Because I was running around doing crazy things. She found some crazy things in the house at the time. Obviously, I'm living in my mum's house at 14, 15.
Yeah.
So by right, she did what she thought was right. And it was the best thing. It saved me, because at the time, there was a drug operation in my town that I would have been a part of. And like about 17, 18 of my friends went to jail. And obviously, she didn't realize what she was doing. But that was why she did it. You know what I mean? But yeah, so I went away for about 20 months, came back, linked up with Six, and then started Six-Figure Music.
It was just meant to be, man.
From there, yeah, man.
Even your relationship with Six, I'm sure anyone that knows about Six-Figure Music too, they would know the relationship between you two that has stayed strong for a long period of time, which you don't really see.
Yeah.
In this industry, you don't see two people stick together.
Yeah.
Me and Six
fight all the time, but we're like brothers. It's not music. Do you know what I mean? Like, obviously, when we have our disagreements and we don't agree on something, it's cool. Like, we're men, we don't agree on it, but you're my brother, do you know what I mean? It don't mean we're gonna fall out over it, or you know what I mean? We just have different opinions on certain things, you know what I mean? He has a way of doing things, I have a way of doing things. Sometimes they clash, but at the end of the day, we want one thing, do you know what I mean? For the team to be successful and for our music to strive and be heard.
100.
Who are your biggest inspirations and source of growing up, basically?
Growing up, inspirations. My mum, my biggest inspiration. Just because
same here,
she's a hustler, man.
Yeah.
You know, like, you don't, like, I don't know, as you get older, you realise, like, bro, it's not easy to, like, look after yourself out here.
For sure.
Like, much less look after, like, my mum had to, like, me and my little brother, do you know what I mean? So like, being able to see her manoeuvre through life and just, like, just always keep going and just getting better and better, do you know what I mean? Moving from job to job and just always just where it's progressing. But yeah, yeah, she's my biggest inspiration.
And what about musically?
Music inspirations, I'd say. I don't know, man. I grew up on a lot of like rap battling.
Right. Okay.
URL. Hey. Like, yeah, I listened to a lot of Tay Rock. I used to listen to back in the day when he was younger.
Yeah.
Before he even got older and everyone. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But music, I don't know, man. I don't even have a lot of music inspirations. It's crazy.
You've
when
got
you
like
that.
A new vibe.
Yeah.
Something different that I like. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, I don't know. I don't listen. It's crazy. Cause I don't. Yeah. When people jump in my car, they're like, "Why don't you listen to music?" It's like,
yeah,
I don't like being influenced. Like, people don't realize you get influenced by a lot of things so easily.
Exactly.
And then you start sounding like things.
Snoop Dogg said that.
Yeah.
He said you don't listen to anybody.
Yeah. Because you get, you don't even realize it, and the next thing you know, you're getting called somebody else.
Exactly.
Know what I mean? So I don't know, man. I didn't have a lot of interest. It was just the people around me, to be honest.
For sure, man.
Yeah, man.
Right. So I wanted to ask you something about. A lot of times you get questions like, what have you learned in the industry, being that you've been in the industry for quite a long time.
Yeah.
But I've more recently become more like infatuated with the idea of unlearning.
Okay.
So what is something that you've had to unlearn growing within this industry?
Something I've had to unlearn. It's relying on other people for a finished product.
Right, right.
It's obviously there's only so much you can do yourself. I'm a rapper, I don't produce to the quality that I'd like to obviously produce to, or engineer or anything like that. So obviously you've got to rely on other people to get your finished product as an artist. But I feel like I'm just trying to do as much, like I said before, I'm trying to do as much as I can myself. So it's kind of, I've had to unlearn relying on other people.
Do
you know what I mean?
Speaking of producing, is that something that you would like to get into?
I actually do produce a little bit. Like, I've played around a bit, but no, it's not something that
I've tried. I can't do it.
To be honest, I just like writing, man.
I was gonna ask you, track nominated, I believe. I think that's your 8th studio.
Eighth. It's my 7th solo tape. But my 8th. It's my 7th solo tape, but my 8th tape.
Okay, so it's the 8th one. What are you planning to do next? And how long did it take you to actually do track to
come out? Track nominated.
Yeah.
Like a month and a half. Yeah,
what
I did, like, I'll tell you the story. The thing is, it's on we documented it on my Snapchat. I got a spare room in my house. What we did was cleared out the spare room and we put a studio in there. And then I started making music from there. But I've just got 2 speakers, got the mic, and got all the little equipment that you need, sound card and whatnot. And I just started leasing beats, getting beats from producers, and making it in my studio. In the first week, I think I did 9 songs in the first 7 days.
What songs were they?
Trap nominated. Everything on the tape, basically, apart from EU and the song was Solo.
Mm,
so I think that's it. Literally everything was just like a month and a half. I literally did it all in my house as well.
For the listeners that are listening in, where can they get that now?
Trap Nominated, it's out everywhere, digital stores worldwide. It's T.E. Dines, Trap Nominated. It's on iTunes, Spotify, Google Play, Amazon.
One thing I wanted to say too was the reception, because you put out a lot of tapes.
I
think, actually, before I even get into that question, I wanted to ask, when it comes to your tapes, is one of your methods to get people to listen to your music is you really do flood. You come with product. You don't stop. So you might come out of 2 mixtapes before someone comes out of 1.
Yeah, yeah.
Is that one of your methods to push?
Nah, not really, because I kind of just feed my internal fan base, man, and kind of just feed myself music. Not a lot of people out there make something that I want to roll to. I'd rather roll to myself than a lot of these people. You know what I'm saying? But it's not my tactic to get people to listen to me. I'm just keeping up with my own pace. You know what I mean? Like, if I dropped a tape at the beginning of the year and I haven't done that much during the middle of the year, because I've been, you know what I mean, personal life stuff, I've got to give you a tape by the end of the year, so you like keep effing with me. You know what I mean?
100.
As a writer, do you ever suffer with writer's block at any point?
Writer's block, yeah.
Really?
Yeah,
because you're very consistent.
I get to a point where I'm saying the same stuff a little bit, so I've got to kick back.
Change it up a bit.
Take a flat here and there and do some things.
One thing that I've noticed with a couple of your songs, you got Girlfriend, Girls in the Hood, Sweet My Way. Some of the songs are for the ladies, but where do you get that inspiration from? Like, for the listeners now, I don't know if you're going to break any of the listeners' hearts.
females are a big inspiration for me. Just like women in general, man. Like you learn a lot from women. Men don't realize that they're the key to everything, man. Like they control a lot of our emotions, a lot of the things we do as men. Do you know what I mean? Like a lot of our validation comes from women.
Mm-hmm. Are you talking about someone
in particular?
Yeah,
in particular. Some of the songs I talk about. Someone in particular. Yeah,
that's real. Also, I wanted to say, going back to what I was saying before about reception, you put out your tape and you can see, you can't ignore it because you got random people retweeting this. You got people putting out for themselves, Instagram, whatever, and then you see someone like Rex 3-2 come out and take the time to tweet out the same album. How did that feel when you even see that right there?
Rex is real. Rex texts me as well. It's like, not even just a tweet. It's just like, these are people, like, it's mad he say Rex, because even like Rex and Scorch, I told them both, like, I grew up listening to you two. So 100%. The fact that you know who I am, like, I'm still just this little kid that had this, like, this dream, so to say. You know what I mean? So being around these kind of people that pick up the phone and speak to them and text them and stuff, it's sick, man. He hit me up and let me know that he listened to it and he liked it. You know what I mean? And then he sent a tweet out, which is just as important, because people don't realise, like with the online help and stuff, other people seeing what you like and you influence people. Do you know what I mean? The fact that he did that means there's a few hundred people that might have said, oh, let me check this out because Rich thinks it's alright. Do you know what I mean?
For
it's
sure.
just as important, man. And he knows how important that kind of public thing is, man.
Where do you see yourself in 5 years? Do you see yourself...
Me? I'm going to be rich as hell.
I like that.
You see yourself raking in the awards, breaking through to the US?
Do you even care? Because that's a question.
We're talking about that.
Do you see what it is? Just with the awards, as time goes by, they mean less. Do you know what I mean? Like Mobos. Let's talk about Mobos, for example. Like this year, Mobos didn't mean what they meant 2 years ago when Stormzy was getting it. Because it's like you saw somebody go from nothing with his video, man, to, you know what I mean? And now there's a lot of industry help. Everyone's claiming to be independent, but everyone's working with labels. It's like, it's not like the independent structure is not the same as it used to be. Right. Like, I understand not signing a deal, but claiming independency when you've got, like, basically you're working as an internal label. It's not the same thing. Do you know what I mean? Like, being independent was when you had your backpack and going to the radio station trying to, you had no manager or nothing. Do you know what I mean? Like, that's kind of where I've been for so long. My thing, like, really independent, like trying to do mixtapes on my own, taking my own bookings and shows, doing everything literally myself. Do you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So I don't know, man. Like, with these awards, like it'd be good to get some kind of awards, just to, like, kind of have them and show my mum something, bring her to a nice award show or something. But for me, I feel like it's more about the music and the people that I inspire, man. Like, there's people out there that are going through uni to my music. You know what I mean? People that graduate and they might write to my song while they're going to go get their cap and gown and these kind of. That means more to me than. Yeah. You know what I mean?
So, it's funny you say that too, because one of my friends from. This is way back. My friend Curtis, shout out to Curtis, would be riding around. He's from Hayes too. He would be riding around listening to you constantly and saying, "Nah, Ty, you need to listen. This guy's live. Yeah. He keeps
seeing." That's what I found, man. Like, people that actually listen to me, they've got that mentality, man. Just that underdog, like, we're gonna win mentality. Mm-hmm. Do you know what I mean? And that's kind of the following that I've been building for so long. So I might not be as popping as other rappers, but I feel like my internal structure is just as strong as anyone else's. Do you know what I mean?
Also, I wanted to say you spoke about something that you grew up on battling.
Yeah.
Now, this is something that I've been fascinated with in the UK right now, because I feel like there's so many talented artists. There's a few people that are in the positions that shouldn't be, and there's some people that are just talented.
Yeah.
You're one of them that's talented. I wanted to say, would you ever indulge in something that is like a rap battle?
Yeah.
If they did create something in the city.
Yeah. I think everyone's scared of that, though.
Hey.
A lot of people are scared.
You gotta remember, London ain't as big as these places. Like, America, you can battle with someone and talk all that nonsense and never see them again, bro. Like, London's a very small place.
Mm. Yeah, exactly. I mean, you might bump into them just anywhere.
No. It could ruin your career as well. You could get a span all over the place
for sure.
No one wants to listen to your music. Hey. You gotta be smart about these things.
So if someone was to come in the right situation and you saw the right artist involved in it,
and it's a battle, rap battle is calm, man. Sure. You mean, man? Yeah, man. Mm. I just go to EMAC for some coaching. Just get me up in the ring, and then we just attack it, man. Mm. Yeah.
EMAC Part of 6.
Yeah,
you put out a great video today.
Yo, tunes mad. Mad. Make sure you guys support that tunes mad. Sure.
Would you say even your whole group, do they inspire you?
Do they inspire me? Kind of rude not to. To say they don't, innit? The man them inspire me, man. I hope I inspire them as much as they inspire me. Do you know what I mean? But just on a live thing, not even just on music, man, just on life. Like, EMAC's a big inspiration for me financially. Like, he's the financial guru. It's okay. A lot. Like, I learn a lot about money from people like that. Mm. You know what I mean? Like, I look for my inspiration in different things. Like, a lot of my friends have like good qualities, and I just take the best qualities from them. Do you know what I mean?
Talking about money, is there anything you would for, like, say there's a rapper coming up right now? He's probably independent. Any recommendations you would have for someone like that?
Yeah, same thing I've been saying all night. Do as much as you can for yourself, because then your money stays in your pocket. Mm. You know what I mean? If you don't have to go to a studio, you can save that studio money for a video. If you learn to produce, you don't have to pay producers. Do you know what I mean? If you learn to mix, you don't have to pay an engineer. Yeah. So you learn to do as much as you can for yourself, and it makes you more independent. You can work at your own speed. You can save your money. Do you know what I mean?
That's
what I tell people coming up. Do as much as you can for yourself. Learn as much as you can. Invest the time now.
What was the hardest thing for you coming up though?
The hardest thing. What, for music?
Yeah, musically.
I'm still coming up, so yeah. The hardest thing is coming up, innit?
You've passed that level. We know who you are.
Yeah, a lot of people do, but do you know what I mean? Like, just like the amount of hours and the amount of time and the amount of pain that I've invested into this, I just feel like it's still underappreciated. Do you know what I mean? To a way,
I hear that.
Like,
just
like to the masses and stuff. I appreciate everyone that listens to my music and how far it's got, just off the back of what it is. You know what I mean? Yeah. The people that push it and stuff. Yeah. But I feel like it's still underappreciated to the masses and that. But not everyone understands it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I had this conversation the other day. My music isn't for everybody. It's not for the kids that are sitting on YouTube all day in the schools going crazy and that.
Do you
kind
know
of
what?
Thing. It's
actually,
a bit of a more.
I disagree.
Yeah.
I actually think you've got, like, let's forget the UK. I see you globally. I see you internationally.
Yeah.
I think your music is that. It might not be out here.
No. It's definitely a worldwide sound. Don't get me wrong. But
sure.
I'm saying in our scene and the way our thing works over here is that like it's a lot of like kids like that, like things with views and things like that. It's a lot of kids in the schools that are just sitting.
Exactly.
And I don't make gimmicks. I don't gimmick rap.
Yeah.
I don't do sing-alongs. I don't do these kind of things that the kids like. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I haven't really branched off and obviously connected with them in that way. Do you know what I mean?
So, is that something you would do or?
I don't know if I happen to make a song, but I'm not going to purposely go out of my way to dumb down the music.
Yeah,
to get
100%.
Also, I would say too. Here's a question that I think anyone that listens to music. Listen to your music for a long time would know. You change your name from TE to TE D-Ness.
D-Ness, yeah.
Normally I can decipher why people make the change, but I couldn't
because TE, but it wasn't searchable online, just two letters. So you couldn't find me.
Yeah.
That was the problem. People couldn't find me. And with D-Ness D-Ness is just a play on my surname, Dennis.
Okay.
So, with D-Ness is, I didn't realise it's gonna be so hard for people to pronounce. So I gotta keep telling people how you pronounce it. But it's just TE D-Ness, so I was searchable online. Mm-hmm. So TE was obviously Temper when I was younger. Temper, MC Temper, whatever you wanna call it. You know what I mean? So TE D-Ness.
And how did the I was looking at it, I saw it online a lot of times and I thought it's going well. You could tell it's going well when you saw going up and down the country with Stormzy.
Yeah.
What was that like?
That was very inspirational for me, man. Like, that was a crazy moment. Obviously a crazy moment in Stormzy's life as well. So just to be a part of it and watch it was good, man. But I think it's sick going to like different places in the country and just having like 5 to 1,000 people, like 1,500 people coming out just to watch you and go crazy. Like, it's sick, man. It's a sick feeling.
For sure.
Just being the opening act was a sick feeling. You know, I felt like they was there for me and they weren't. You know what I mean? It's inspirational. Man, like, it's crazy, man.
And even down to the fact that I see you, I'm sure, was it Tiger once? I'm sure there was
we did Tiger. We did Future at the beginning of this year.
Yeah.
We did Section Boys tour.
Being an independent artist, how are we getting to these positions where you're constantly?
Well, I don't know. People believe in me, man.
Mm.
Like, people just holler at me and just give me these opportunities, and I'm always grateful and I always kill it when I get them. You know what I mean? So that's what it is. They keep coming up because I do my job, man.
As I look at T, I'm sitting there thinking this rap battles need to be happening. I'm sitting there thinking it needs to be happening. Someone needs to set something up.
We need to keep
where
it cool,
happening.
Man. No, that kind of sauce.
I hear that. Now, also, even going forward, what would you say is happening for you?
Me, I'm gonna do a headline show. I just need to put it out there just so people know it's coming. I'm gonna do a headline show, the Trap Nominated show. I've got some sick ideas, man. But I just can't wait to perform this new music off this tape. So I'm definitely gonna do a headline show.
Mm-hmm.
Whoever's listening now, I'm gonna announce it on Sunday.
There you go.
I'm hiding that.
Exclusive out here.
Tickets will go tickets will go on sale on my birthday next Wednesday.
Where can we cop them?
It'll be Ticketweb, I think.
Okay.
Ticketweb.
Man's copying one for sure.
One of them,
I'll be there. You were copying one. We knew you were copying one. But
I'm gonna do the headline. I won't tell you when it is, but we're gonna do the headline and keep the videos coming for the new tape. I've got some remixes and stuff to do from the tape as well. And then don't know, April Showers 3 or Trap Nominated 2, really.
So if for the listeners that want to hear more, where, what's all your socials?
So it's TE_DNESS. That's TE_DNESS. And that's on everything. That's Twitter, Snapchat, Instagram. Or you just type in TE space DNESS on Google and it just brings you to everything, really.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, so that was TEDNS for sure. This is a good one. This was a unanswered questions I wanted to know today.
No, thank you. Thank you for having me.
100%. So we've got Timeless DJ coming on next, and then on the Monday.
Celine and Noel.
Oh, it's Celine. Shout out to them. I don't know who Timeless. Shout out Timeless. Out here.
It's Wednesday.
But on Monday too, we got George the Poet. So like, we know that's going to be another epic one.
Epic. Trust me. I have to come down to get an autograph for that.
How you mean?
So get a little Instagram up.
Trust me. You go do your thing. How you mean?
See them lacks already.
So LDN RBS will be back next week. Let's go home with it. Hey.